and welcome to my CM30 student choice. With me is Mr. Glaspey. So Mr. Glaspey, what are your expectations for students in your class?
Well, Clayton, as a student in my class, am I supposed to look here at you? Where?
That one.
Okay, Clayton, you know as a student in my class, I expect you to come on time, which he seldom does. He's often late. I expect you to come with a good attitude, which he usually does when he's not sleeping, and, you know, just a willingness to learn. In seriousness, I know that when I teach a core subject, not all students want to learn history, or social, or, you know, whatever the case may be, but I think it's worthwhile to learn, and hopefully if people come with an open mind, they'll end up having a lot of fun, and learning a lot, too.
How many years have you been teaching?
At the end of this season, it'll be my 25th year. Quarter of a century!
Congratulations.
Yep. 9 years in Cornac, Saskatchewan, and this will be 16 years in Weyburn.
If you could describe Mr. Witness in one word, what would it be?
Oh, that's tough. So many come to mind. Magnificent. Stellar. Ridiculous. Why don't you join me? What are some of your words?
Good teacher?
Well, I wouldn't say good teacher. I'd say aspiring to be a good teacher. Maybe.
Okay. Are you close to the same level of teaching as Mr. Ornis?
No. Monty's a lot older than me, as you know. Like, he looks like an old man because he is. But that's because he was a hippie in his, you know, earlier life. He wandered around. He tried his hand at carpentry and running a lumber store and, you know, being a flower child in Manor, Saskatchewan, which didn't go well for him because lots of cowboys there. So finally they ran him out of town. You know, he would have probably lived in a box. Luckily he was married to a wife smart enough to become a teacher. I don't know what happened. There must have been money that changed hands for him to get a degree, but who cares? He got a degree. So he's been teaching, sort of, if that's what you call what he does, but he'll never have the experience that I have. It's sad, really, you know. He tries hard. I mean, he tries.
Yeah.
Well, I shouldn't say that. He used to try hard. If you really watch Monty nowadays, he's kind of given up. I try to inspire him and pick him up and say, come on, Monty, you can, but it's hard.
Yeah.
And especially when summer comes and he's got the attention span on a gnat, so...
Okay, what are your thoughts on Mr. Ernest?
Really?
Yep.
Monty's one of my best friends, and I mean that sincerely, and it's fun to come to work with him, and rock on, Monty. There.
Awesome. Take me down to the paradise.